Hi, here's Paula J and welcome to the new episode of CQURE Hacks. Let's start with the big why. Why USB security is so important? First of all, USB port still is an unmanaged port within the companies. And we all know that it's also a way to deliver different types of attacks. So in this video series, we're going to learn what are the devices and how to configure them in order to make the attack through USB. So everything you need to know about USB security. No time to lose, let's dig in. So what you see right now on the screen, it's a hacker's machine, and we are using netcat-l-v-p on the port 443. So let's start it. And what I'm going to do right now on my side, I'm going to stick in that DigiSpark into one of my USB ports. So 3, 2, 1, let's do it. And just in a couple of seconds, you're going to be able to see the connection that's coming on the hacker site. So that particular USB drive executes underneath PowerShell, and what it does next, it actually connects using the reverse shell into the hacker's box. So it also shows us the necessity of well configured whitelisting, because eventually PowerShell being such a great thing, everybody is able to use it. Even though you are a user, you might be able to use it for the unprivileged operations, but it doesn't really matter, because you will be able, for example, to run the script that we're going to be running, and we are running from that USB drive. So eventually, if we do who am I right now, you can see that I'm Paula. So I'm right now remotely accessing my own computer, and from that perspective, I'm also able to demonstrate that we are able to control particularly the user's machine by, for example, performing the screenshot or eventually accessing the web camera and so on. So there are plenty of things we can do. So I have over here a couple of samples of activities, but let's have a look live how eventually we are able to escalate ourselves, to move ourselves to be able to do different operations. So over here, I will just paste a pulse exploitation library. That's our custom library, CQ pulse exploit lib PS1, that allows us to load different sets of CMD LEDs from the hacker perspective. So I got over here, get screenshot, and let's run it. And that will allow me, for example, to make a screenshot of the things that I'm able to see right now. So for example, if I do get screenshot right now, then basically screenshot is taken. So that's one thing. Let's just do a couple of things at once, and then we'll be able to review them. And then get webcam snapshot, for example. So why not? Let's give it a try. Here we go. Okay, awesome. So hopefully it worked out. And eventually key recording. Yes, so everything that I'm going to be typing, you'll be able to see as well in this console. So if I do start key recording, then if I, for example, launch Notepad, you guys are able to see it, and everything, whatever password I type in, you are able to see it on the screen. So that is an attack for the longest possible passwords, because when the user is typing them, we are able to record the keystrokes. And also my favorite, that is related with the clipboard replacement, and that is related with the possibility to, for example, attack on the finance department that is doing transfers. And they've got like invoices, and eventually we are able to attack, for example, the situation where someone has an invoice and there is an account on the invoice, and we are copying this particular account. So let's give it a try, and then the clipboard on the fly will be replaced. Okay, so let's see how the copying works normally. Okay, so I am right now copying live this account number, and that's exactly the same account. But if we go over here into the attack mode, we are able to replace the account number with our own account. And of course, the rest will go as usual. Yeah? So the transaction will be confirmed by the SMS and all that stuff, but it doesn't really matter, because we are actually transferring to the wrong account. Anyway, so I'm copying this one right now, copy. And in the same Notepad, we're gonna go in here and to paste, and you are able to see that that particular clipboard has been replaced. So long story short, we've been performing different operations. Let's just hit refresh. So what we got for today, and that was basically the screenshot activity, so you guys could see what I'm seeing, and then as well, that's basically the picture. Maybe we can just go further, and then over here we've got the keylogging activity recorded in a really nice form. Yeah, so that is the way. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure that you're going to visit our blog, CQUREacademy.com/blog, where you are able to download the tools, not only seen in this episode, but also from the other episode. And also in the blog, you're going to find more interesting episodes like this. See you there.